Nairobi-based blogger Anthony Njoroge Mburu, who allegedly accused Kiambu Governor William Kabogo of importing substandard eggs in a Facebook post, was expected to know his fate today. Well, we are now joined by our reporter Francis Ontoma by way of phone for the latest. Ontoma, what can you tell us now?
Well, good afternoon, Betty. And the very latest that we have at the moment is the blogger Anthony Mburu has been released by the Mombasa High Court here, and he has been released under Section 87A, which basically means that he has been released, and the prosecution will have more time now to go out, fish out for more evidence, cement their case, and come back to court. Basically, it is some sort of a win for the prosecution, because all along this is what they have been praying for. They have been asking for more time to go and cement their case. And on the defense side, they were asking for Mburu to be released unconditionally under Section 210, which basically means that this will have terminated this case altogether. It is a case that, as you've realized, has attracted a lot of interest. You've seen people travel from as far as Nairobi to be here in Mombasa to know which way the Anthony Mburu case. Just for a bit of a background, Betty, that Anthony Mburu was arraigned in court last week, of course. He was brought here in court, charged by some organization that was saying that he was selling their reputation. And this is a poultry farm that is based in Kwale, which had raised concern that Mburu had actually made a Facebook post that had implicated them with Kiambu Governor William Kabogo over the importation of substandard eggs into the country. And actually what he was saying is that they were using the farm as a cover-up to be able to bring this particular goods into the country. Therefore, it's still not over for Anthony Mburu, Betty. We are still waiting to see how the prosecution will handle this particular affairs, because should they find more evidence, they will still have a window to come back to court and file the case again, Betty.
Right. Thank you very much, Francis Ontoma, there reporting from Mombasa.